The views and opinions expressed do not necessarily reflect those of Access Fort Wayne, the Allen County Public Library, or any other supporting groups. If you'd like to produce a show, call us at 260-421-1250.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Hallelujah.
Amen. 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 Amen.
Get in this chair. You don't have a chair.
Amen. Merry Christmas to everybody.
Merry Christmas.
Amen. God is in the blessing business.
Amen.
Amen. This devotional that I'm going to do is called Everlasting Love. Because the Lord loves us forever. No matter what we do, He's going to continue to love us. It says, God loves you with an everlasting love. His love runs deeper than any love that you've ever experienced. His love is indescribable. His love is endless. The signature of His love runs deeper than the foundations of the earth. Before the formation of the earth, God loved you.
Amen.
His love is everlasting, and His greatness is unsearchable.
Yes.
Who is like our God? No one can compare to His loving kindness. Nothing can compare to His outstretched arms. His love will lift you up out of any pit that you may face.
Amen.
His love will conquer every stronghold that you may battle. His love will block any assignment, trap, and snare that the enemy tries to deploy.
Amen.
His love will lead you through the wilderness. His love will protect you through the storm.
Yes.
His love is marvelous and nothing can compare.
Amen.
There is no mountain that can stand before Him. His love will go before you. His love will crush every giant that stands in your way. Who are you, great mountain? There is nothing that can defeat Him. Nothing can outrank Him. His love breaks every generational curse, struggle, and stronghold. His love plows mountains and is a weapon that defeats every obstacle. His love stands forever. His love is freedom. Amen.
Amen.
I thank God for His love for loving all of us today. It's an amazing, it's just so amazing to be loved by the Lord and to know it. Amen. Well, I'm ready to praise the Lord in song. Are you guys ready to praise Him in song?
Yes.
Those of you who can stand, if you would like to stand as we sing praises to our Lord and King. How great is our God? Amen.
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 Let all the earth be sure. I'm not going to hold you have a busy day, and I know many of you want to get to your families. If you would turn with me in your Bibles to Luke chapter 2, verse 11. Father God, as I decrease, you increase within me. We thank you for this day, God. We thank you for what you've done. We thank you for your precious Holy Spirit. We thank you, God, for giving us your Son, Jesus, Lord, that came to set all the captives free. And we thank you, Father God, for the opportunity to celebrate this day, Lord God, in remembrance of his birth. And we glorify your name, and we give you the glory, the honor, and the praise. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. If you have in your Bibles Luke chapter 2, verse 11, when you find it, please stand for the reading of God's word. Luke chapter 2, verse 11. Thank you, Jesus. Luke chapter 2, verse 11. It says, today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. May God add a blessing to the reading, hearing, and doing of his word. You may be seated. As I stated, I won't keep you long. And as I was praying about today, I said, Lord, what is it that you want me to share with your people? He gave me one word, and that word was life. L-I-F-E.
Amen.
Okay?
Life.
God gave us Jesus. He was born in a manger, the L, so that we will be set free from the bondage of Satan, set free from hell and damnation. He gave us, through a baby, life. Jesus was our salvation. He came as a baby to bring us life. And all we have to do is accept and believe that he is, that he came for us to set us free. If you accept him as your Lord and Savior, you have life everlasting.
Amen.
Did I say it was going to be easy? No, because Satan is still in this world. So many people believe that when they accept Jesus as their Lord and Savior, that everything is going to be hunky-dory, everything is going to be okay. Well, you know what? When you accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior, as you're growing in him, you're going to be able to overcome a lot of things. But the enemy is going to always be at your back.
Yes.
But the Bible says, resist the devil and he will flee.
Amen.
How do you resist him? You resist him through your faith in Jesus Christ. Amen. You resist him by accepting the precious Holy Spirit that is here to lead and guide and watch and protect and show you the right way to go. You resist him by getting into his word. You resist him by not going back into the way things used to be in your life. But you press forward towards the mark of the high calling in Christ Jesus. You resist the devil through loving your neighbors and your fellow man. You resist the devil by treating others the way you would have them to treat you.
Amen.
You resist the devil by blessing and praising and worshiping and lifting up the name of Jesus. Amen. God is always here for us. He'll always show us the right way to go. All we got to do is follow. He came to give us life. He came to allow us, through his precious birth, through his precious life, the choice to live with him, independent of all the things that the devil and this world tries to give us and tries to bring upon us. Through him, we have the independence of being a child of God, living according to his word, being blessed by him. I'm going to tell you, if you ever trust God to the point of not being concerned about what is going to happen today or tomorrow, if you ever get to the point of trusting him and having faith, I mean just that little mustard seed faith, God will bless you in ways that you have never ever seen before.
Amen.
You got to trust him. You can't live straddling the fence. You can't live in the wall and live for him. You got to give God your all.
Amen.
And when you do that, he will give you his all. Everything that we ask God for, he has it for us. But he will not bless mess. He will not bless in a disobedience. He will not do that. He wants us to be blessed in all ways and everything that we desire. But we got to do it his way.
Amen.
We can't do it any other way but his way. He wants us to have faith, L-I-F, faith. Faith in him. Faith in his word. Faith that he is going to bless you. Faith that he is never going to leave you or forsake you. Faith is what we live by. Faith in his precious Holy Spirit. Faith is what he gave us, even through that baby that was born. Today, we should have faith. God knew that he was going to have somebody that was totally independent of everything in this world, that was not a part of this world, to set us free. So in Philippians, it said he wrapped himself in flesh, was born of a virgin, walked this earth for 33 years to show us through faith everything will be all right. All we got to do is trust and believe. And the last thing is, if you want everlasting life, if you're not concerned about where your last resting place is going to be, then you must trust God. You must believe in him. You must believe on his word. Most of all, you must accept him. When you accept him, eternal life. Can you imagine? There are so many people walking around don't know when they close their eyes where they're going to go. But those of us who have accepted Jesus as our Lord and Savior know where we're going to go. So that journey on a hop from this life to the next life, it's not that hard of a journey, because you know you might close your eyes in this world, but you're going to wake up with the Father. What a joyous time. What a happy time. What a time we're going to have being able to be right in his face, to see him, to know that we are saved by his blood.
Amen.
We're saved. Beginning with the birth, we are saved, and I thank God for that. It's so important that we are saved, but we also got to reach others. We can't leave anybody behind.
Amen.
You never know what God is doing with an individual through you. You got to believe. God has given us eternal life as his children. And as his children, we need to continue every day when we close our eyes at night, thank you, Jesus. When we wake up the next morning, thank you, Jesus. Because we don't know if when you close your eyes at night, that's going to be your last day of seeing anybody. So you better be ready. You better make sure in your heart that you're ready. So when you close your eyes, if you wake up in eternity, you know you're ready. We got to get ready, church. We've got to be ready. God told me to tell you, life came through that baby, through Jesus. Life, if we accepted it, we have eternal life. God bless you.
Amen. Amen.
I'm going to keep this. I need Dale to come on up. He's our Santa today.
Oh, yeah.
God is good. I tell you, you might look at this altar and you might say, the church sure spent a lot of money to give us gifts. Most of these gifts came from someone else.
Happy holidays from all of us at Parkview Health.
Won't stop till your kingdom come. Because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men.
Amen. This song is called, Would the Lord Help Me to Do This? Mary, Did You Know? Praise God. Mary, did you know? that your baby boy will one day walk on water. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you deliver will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would calm a storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby walk where angels trod? When you kiss your little baby, you kiss the face of God. Oh, Mary, did you know? Yes, thank you, Lord. Mary, did you know? The blind will see, the dead will hear, the dead will live again. Oh, the lame will lead, the dumb will stay, the praises of the land. Oh, Mary, did you know? That your baby boy is Lord of all creation. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will one day rule the nation? Did you know that your baby boy was heaven's perfect lamb and a sleeping child you're holding is a grave? Mary, did you know? Oh, Mary, did you know? Praise God. You know, the Bible said she pondered these things in her heart, what the angel had told her and what her son would. Girls, come on up and we'll start. I'll get us back to where we can work with what we got here. Since we already did that way in a manger, we'll do a little town of Bethlehem, okay? Little town of Bethlehem. There you go. Come over this way, you can see what you're singing. Dark street shine the everlasting light. The hopes and fears of all the years are met in thee tonight. For Christ is born of Mary and gathered all
such a wandering love. Oh, morning stars together proclaim thy holy birth, and praises sing to God the King, and peace to men on earth. Child of Bethlehem, he said to us, we pray, cast out our sin and enter in, be born in us today. We hear the Christmas angels, the great glad tidings tell. Oh, come to us, abide with us, our Lord Emmanuel. Thank you, Lord. Praise God.
I've got Rusty Mary Gentleman, but I don't see it on here.
They went to go rest.
My eyes aren't as good as they used to be. They can see something quicker than I can. God rest you, Mary Gentleman.
God rest ye merry gentlemen, let nothing you dismay. Remember Christ our Savior was born on Christmas Day, to save us all from Satan's power when we were gone astray. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy. In Bethlehem in Israel, this blessed babe was born, and laid within a manger upon this blessed morn, to which his mother Mary did nothing take him store. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy. From God our Heavenly Father a blessed angel came, and unto certain shepherds brought tidings of the same. How then in Bethlehem was born the Son of God by name. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy.
Jingle bells. This is the country version of it. It's all right we do jingle bells, isn't it?
Yeah. As long as you don't jingle.
Okay.
But what if we do?
I'll do the verses, okay?
Dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh, o'er the field we go, laughing all the way. Filled on bobtails ring, making spirits bright. What fun it is to ride and sing a sleighing song tonight. Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in one horse open sleigh. Hey, hear those bells, jingle bells, jingling all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Hey.
Jingle bells, jingling all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Now, a day or two ago, I thought I'd take a ride. And soon Miss Fanny Bright was seated by my side. The horse was lean and lank, but his fortune seemed his lot. We got into a drifting bank, and then we got a sock.
What?
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Hey.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Ooh, I'm all jingled out. Merry Christmas.
You ain't got no more jingle?
Praise God. All right, let's see if we've got that. Winter Wonderland is really not a bad little song. And we do White Christmas. And somewhere up, I can find my mouse here.
A beautiful sight, we're happy tonight, walking in a winter wonderland. Gone away is a bluebird, here to stay is a new bird. He sings a love song as we go along, walking in a winter wonderland. In the meadow we can build a snowman, and pretend that he is Parson Brown. He'll say, are you married? We'll say, no, man. But you can do the job when you're in town. Later on, we'll conspire as we dream by the fire to face unafraid the plans that we made, walking in a winter wonderland.
I like that 40-degree weather out there today. We didn't snow at Christmas time.
In the meadow we can build a snowman and pretend that he's a circus clown. We'll have lots of fun with Mr. Snowman until the alligators knock him down. When it snows, ain't it thrilling? Though your nose gets a-chillin', we'll frolic and play the Eskimo way, walking in a winter wonderland. The face on a frame, the plan that we made, walking in a winter wonderland.
Do White Christmas and I'll come back to another gospel Christmas song. Joy to the world. Bing Crosby style.
Cheers. Christmas card I write. May your days be merry and bright, and may all your wishes be mine. I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to
King. Rock hills and blood, rock hills and plain. Repeat the sounding joy, repeat the sounding joy.
Happy holidays from all of us at Parkview Health.
On the first day of Christmas, my Parkview gave to me a hospital in my community. On the second day of Christmas, my Parkview gave to me two acts of love and a hospital in my community. On the third day of Christmas, my Parkview gave to me three true friends, two acts of love and a hospital in my community.
Chose West Maine. You don't know how far you're reaching. You don't know the person that came to me, and I can't share where that was from, but came to me and said, do you have children at your church? I said, yes. He said, I want to bless the children at your church.
Amen.
They could have went to anyone else, mm-hmm. but they chose West Maine
yes.
and the children that come to this church. That means we're doing something right.
Amen.
That means God is looking down upon us and blessing us. We got to make sure that we stay right. Right with God most of all. Right within ourselves that we're living according to His word. Everything is going to be all right.
Amen.
You have Carl and Tatiana, they can come down. I know they're probably serving food. I'm getting food ready.
I can go get them.
Okay, I need Carl and Tatiana down. So, Lord, we thank you for the bounty that you have given. We thank you for the gifts that the others have given to us to give back to our people. We give you the glory, the honor, and all the praise for what you have done. And we thank you now in Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 Some of these are gifts that I purchased just to bless you, but the majority of them came from others. So, Dale, I'm going to let you travel around.
Okay.
Thank you. Let's see where we're going to go first. Oh, my goodness.
Can I say one thing first?
Yes, yes, here. Okay.
Just to share one thing I had seen these past couple of weeks. Was a slogan or a saying on a marquee of a business, and I can't remember which one it was. Just keep in your heart and in your mind, and this isn't my original saying, but I just thought it was so wonderful, I gotta share it. The greatest gift came in a manger, not in a sleigh.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Praise Jesus. Okay, let's see what we got here. It's a little bit of everything. Okay. I need Eddie. I need Charles and his sister.
Marie.
Thank you. That's Eddie. This is Marie.
Open it up.
Do this for me. Move it around, trying to follow it. This is hard for me to do it on both.
I'm gonna let you hold this here, but I can't
walk and talk.
How
can you walk and talk? No, all you gotta do is move it.
Okay.
Just move it on a tripod.
Charles.
Let me see. Stop messing with stuff.
I didn't mess with it.
My Facebook crap is going up and I can
pee. Let me see. I kind of get sad in here.
Turn it around just like that, some more here.
I am.
No, this way.
Carl.
You know what? Let me don't. Keep it up front. And what I would do is don't face it right on. No, face that way. I would do Facebook live on.
Those are yours.
Your phone first. I don't use your phone first. Let's keep following since your phone is being, it's not working.
Another boy.
pick up all the paper. We're going to throw it in the trash.
Ooh, that's big.
Open. That's
Eddie.
Open,
okay, you gonna get
your open his gifts, Tatiana. No. Open his gifts, Tatiana. No. What did I say?
Who is this from, bud?
We're all kids.
Okay. Oh, this is from Sammy? My,
from JJ. She wanted to sit here. Come over here, Eddie. You got a big box to open.
Here.
Open the gift.
I just got a gift card.
No, Eddie, not that. Over here. Those belong to somebody else.
Don't you get your Sunday,
this
bud.
This is from his aunt from out of town. From Katie, from Texas. From Texas.
What?
Oh.
And you guys, all the children, you got another gift coming. It'll be, hopefully I have a Sunday. You got some more things coming.
Now why she wrapping it then she was going to put it in the box?
Eddie! Come here,
Eddie.
Leave alone, we'll have to let you all say something. Hi, everybody. Come look what you got, Eddie.
Huh?
You and your daddy.
Come on, he don't need to look, Eddie. Look.
Eddie, come here.
He
said, oh, what's this?
Okay, open it up.
Open it. The fifth Elmo. Ooh, this is make what? Number four.
I love.
The fifth Elmo. Lots of love.
Remember that, bud?
Shirt.
When you was a kid?
Yeah.
Look.